A manufacturer must conduct a complete thermal analysis when a significant component change affects cooling in a pad supply or other IT part. During this procedure, thermal probes are carefully attached to all crucial parts inside the PSU, not to affect airflow at its internals. You push it to the absolute maximum to find out whether this component change has affected its reliability and operation, and if this is the case, to what degree compared to the original configuration. We'll do this today with the Seasonic Prime Noctua TX-1600 and the original TX-1600. According to Noctua, this PSU is around 8 to 10 decibels quieter than the regular version in the 17 to 100% fan speed range. This means that the fan speed profile is more relaxed, but Noctua also changed the fan and the top cover. There are no other changes at the internals, with both PSUs also using the same heatsinks. Both PSUs will be tested in the same Chroma AT station using the same testing fixture, AC and DC cables, and remote sense cables. The PSUs will be installed into a temperature controlled box facing upwards to monitor fan speed through a tachometer. The testing will start when the ambient inside the chamber reaches 45 degrees Celsius and will be raised to 50 degrees Celsius, where it will be kept steady. The total test duration will be 16 minutes and the input voltage and frequency will be 115 volt and 60 Hz respectively. Both PSUs were loaded for 10 minutes at 50% to reach the proper operating temperatures. Usually, thermal analysis is conducted at the lowest possible voltage, even 90 volt for 1 to 2 hours. The official specs of the TX-1600 say, though, that the full load can be only applied to the 115 to 240 volt range. For voltage input lower than 115 volt and up to 100 volt, the full load is restricted to 1300 watt. So, I couldn't drop below 150 volt if I wanted to apply full load, given that I wanted to follow strictly the official specifications. How do you secure the thermal probes inside the PSU? With glue. You also have to route them properly, not to disrupt the internal airflow. Moreover, the thermal probe gauges are thin enough for this purpose. The outcome. The average delta temperature difference between the TX-1600 and the Noctua Edition TX-1600 is just 0.44%. But this number only doesn't tell the whole truth. The PFC FETs are cooled way better in the TX-1600. I don't like that the temperature in the first PFC MOS gets close to 94 degrees Celsius. This is at 115 volt AC input, which won't be the case under full load at real life conditions, where there will be a notable voltage drop on the AC socket. The lower the voltage input, the higher the amps, leading to increased thermal loads in the EPFC converter. The main FETs are cooled better in the TX-1600 Noctua Edition, but they don't get too hot in the TX-1600 either. The significant improvement of the TX-1600 NE is on the main transformer, where the smaller fan provides better cooling, leading to notably lower temperatures. The main transformer doesn't have a problem operating even at high temperatures. The lower the temperature, the better, of course. The resonant chokes are cooled slightly better in the TX-1600 NE. The 12-volt heatsink gets notably hotter in the TX-1600 NE on one side, registering a 10.5% higher temperature. The larger fan on the TX-1600 leads to better temperatures in the VRM circuits that handle the minor rails. At the end of the test, the TX-1600 NE is notably quieter, with a 13 decibel noise difference. According to all above, someone can say that the TX-1600 Noctua Edition is the clear winner because of the notably lower noise output and the slight average delta difference. But there is more. I noticed something strange that might change the result. Remember that in the test methodology I mentioned that I used the same Chroma ATE, the same fixture, and all cabling and the remote sense cables were the same. Look at the voltage levels on all rails. For some reason, all rails have a much lower voltage output in the TX-1600NE, with the largest difference at 12 volt, which is the most important. There were no voltage drops during the testing session due to the increased temperatures and loads. The TX-1600NE just started at this low voltage level compared to the plain TX-1600 and stayed there. The change of fan and its top cover in the Noctua Edition TX-1600 brings a notable improvement only to the main transformer, because the smaller fan focuses its airflow in this region. Still, the PFC FETs have notably higher temperatures, reaching close to 100 degrees Celsius, with the input voltage steady at 150 volt, which won't be the case in real-life scenarios with the PSU at full load, because there will be a notable voltage drop on the AC socket. This makes me worry that there might be issues with the fan change only under extremely stressful scenarios, and a beefier heatsink is required for the PFC FETs and parts of the PSU where the smaller fan provides lesser airflow. When you design a PSU and offer a 12-year warranty, you must be prepared for the worst-case scenario, not the ideal one. Moreover, the heatsink cooling of the 12-volt FETs gets notably hotter in the Noctua Edition unit. I couldn't measure the 12-volt FETs directly without affecting the heatsink's operation, but having a close to 10.5% increase in temperature at 150 volt input and 9.5% at 230 volt is not a good sign. The same rise in temperature is also evident in the VRMs generating the minor rails. The smaller fan in the Noctua Edition PSU tightens the airflow to a specific region in the PSU, improving it in this region, which is not so important since the main transformer can handle the heat and operate without issues even at high temperatures. At the same time, parts like MOSFETs have lower temperature limits and are generally more sensitive to high operating temperatures. Given the 12-volt year warranty in both TX-1600 editions, I would go for the plain TX-1600 despite the higher noise output under stressful conditions. Always keep in mind that lowering the noise output comes at a cost when you don't use larger heatsinks, which cost more, and there is also the tooling and redesign cost that should be considered. Another thing that bothers me about the Noctua Edition unit is the notably lower 12-volt rail voltage level compared to the original TX-1600. I cannot explain why this happened and the purpose of lowering this rail in the Noctua Edition unit. The review sample I tested a while ago didn't drop below 12 volt, even at 110% load at 46.7 degrees Celsius. And to answer the video's title, whether the Noctua Edition TX-1600 is reliable, in the short period, 1 hour, I applied full load at 150 volt and at 50 degrees Celsius, it didn't fail. This is a good sign, but according to the PSU's specification, it is supposed to be able to deliver a full load at such high temperature indefinitely. Still, I noticed notably higher temperatures in sensitive parts, APC converter, 12-volt FETs, minor rail VRMs. This powerful PSU is supported by an extended warranty and is destined for high-end systems with energy-hungry components. I cannot know how users will treat it and how it will fare in the long run. I would feel safer with the original TX-1600. The Honghua fan used in the original TX-1600 has almost double the airflow of the Noctua fan, which matters the most in a PSU and has notably higher static pressure. That is all, guys. Subscribe to our channel and Till the next video. Bye bye.